Welcome friends, welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. I am Tolmoy. So today I shall explain about a main reaction, that is a Julia-Kosinski reaction. And this reaction is actually an extension of Julia reaction, means Julia olefination. I have already made a previous video about Julia reaction and its modification, where I have explained the phenomena in details. Actually this reaction also follows a similar type of pathway. And I, since I have explained on this video, I suggest you please go first read that video, and after that you come to this video. I shall provide the link. And secondly, here I am not going to explain too much on mechanism part because I have already explained. So let's start. Actually, the main thing in case of Julia olefination, what is used? Let me tell you one part. It will be useful for you. There is use these sulfones, okay, and here anion is generated and that have done the reaction. Instead of that, so it's a sulfur thiazole, 5 member rings containing sulfur and nitrogen. Here the reaction is carried out in presence of a tetrazole unit. So before going to details, I want to give you a little understanding about tetrazole. It contains 4 nitrogen in a 5 member ring. Please keep it in mind, 4 nitrogen in a 5 member ring, because such tetrazole molecules are highly explosive. So care must be taken while handling this. What happens, this molecule can produce 2 molecules of nitrogen and some other product, and nitrogen is a very stable molecule and gas, so it will come out. So it is necessary to take precaution while handling tetrazoles. So what happens, this is the alpha position and acidic proton is here, so this could be abstracted in presence of base. Like actually here I have written KNSI-NH3, this could be addressed at KHMDS. Previously in Julia I have shown lithium HMDS, it is the potassium version. Second, when KHMDS is used, absolute inert condition is necessary. I have used this reagent my myself. It needs flank line and a dry gas, even argon should be dried properly. So okay, fine. So and this required very low temperature, as the reagent is very very reactive. Even taking this reagent outside with air produces burning. I have observed that. So this, and instead of that, if this reaction needs to be carried out in use of cesium carbonate, this temperature enhancement could be possible at 70 degrees. So two type of condition could be utilized, and this result reaction of a trans or e-alkene. Okay, e or trans alkene. So what happens, since after this KHMDS production, I will give you a short about this reagent. This is the nitrogen, this is the silicon, this is, so you can see how much bulkiness, and another thing counter is potassium. So what happens, this is a very bulky, highly reactive reagent, and specifically it abstracts protons, so it will not never react this double bonds, this position. So it will selectively abstract proton from here to produce that carbon ion, which is actually a nucleophile. Okay, and this carbon center is electrophilic center, so it will go and attack, and it will produce a final hydroxy derivative. And this hydroxy derivative will follow similar pathway like Julia, modified Julia reaction, and produce. So what we will do first, it will prepare, let's draw it. Okay, it will produce this intermediate. Okay, and this intermediate will attack this, because this is like a carbonyl, means here is nitrogen, but reactivity of this group is like a carbonyl. Okay, so it will attack here, it will go here. Consequently, what will produce after that? In this way, it will produce a ring. Means, how many number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, I suggest you this to adopt such counting method, because it will reduce the chance of mistake. Okay? So, this is R1. It is also a 5 member ring. So, this is nitrogen, this is have negative, and all this is a tetrazole, 4 nitrogen, so everything will remain as it is. So this is okay, fine. After that, what happens, since this nitrogen is electron rich, it can push here and it will go. So see the changes. Previously oxygen have attacked this center, right now sulfur is leaving, and in this way reduction of sulfur happens. Okay, so this reduction of sulfur, this reduction of sulfur will produce. I suggest you to draw as it is the thing, no, don't change everything. And if possible, try to follow a numbering system. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will reduce the chance of mistake. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So here sulfur is reduced, and next step what happens, these bond undergo rotation. Why? Because here they were closer, but here they will undergo anti-orientation. I have explained the why anti and how happens, and this, please see that after this, what happens, this will come back, this bond will come here, and actually it is under anti, not this case. I say first, okay. Better let me draw it. So it's a tetrazole. Tetrazole O. This is R. So here should be R2. Here should be R1. Here should be, after this SO elimination, means if we consider this, this is SO O minus. So what happened? These will push. These will push, and this will be anti, because the donation of the electron pair that is produced, this carbon ion is produced to the sigma star of this bond. Okay, this bond sigma star. So in this way, E1CB type path will be followed. Or you can see, actually it could be not E1CB, it could be E2 type, means under same conditions. So in this way, sulfur dioxide will come out and it will produce the corresponding transalkene as a product. So this is the whole mechanistic description. The main difference is use of a tetrazole, which is relatively more electron deficient. Okay, so this is that another modification of Joule reaction. So let's discuss one example. What happens during the synthesis of this calistine A? Two methods, Julia olefination is used to prepare the trans intermediate. So we'll discuss the one, which is this. Why I am giving such type of example, which is too much complicated? Because nowadays you have observed many questions are coming with multiple stereo isomer. Actually, the thing is not difficult, but the substitutes are difficult, and I believe it's a strategy to confuse. So you will get confused. Whatever the thing, you will forget, you will focus on these many asymmetric centers, you will be confused because here contains one, in this way many asymmetric centers are there, you will be confused and you will end up with mistake. So that's why it is better to have some practice with some asymmetric complicated molecule. So if you are comfortable with complicated molecules, so in exam hall you will not be surprised or uncomfortable. So let's continue. This reaction, what happening? Actually, this is the active site center. Means here the NaHMDS, I have explained about KHMDS, here the anion is sodium, is abstract this proton, and here the anion is generated, which undergo reaction with this aldehyde. So this part is the main thing which is undergoing the reaction. So you have to follow only this. And what is NaHMDS? You know, HMPM means, for your practice I am telling again, it will be a remember thing. So this is a polar aprotic solvent. Another thing, it stabilizes the cation. First, consequently, the reactivity of anion increases, and DME is nothing but dimethoxyethylene. And since this KHMDS is used as a reagent, so temperature is minus 78 degree. But I believe always you write argon and dry condition. It is better because this reagents are very much reactive. So ultimately what happens, this reacts to produce a, this double bond is produced here and produced this E isomer or trans isomer. So this is one of the application of Joule alkylation. So this is the end of the video. If you like my teaching, please give a like and subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecules, and please share this video among your friends such that many people could be benefited from my effort. And finally, please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. So, see you in my next video.